So first we'll study levels of work ethos. In that, first level is discipline. When I talk about discipline, it's the manner in which you perform your work at the best. Whatever work you have, you are given as an employee, you should follow discipline in it. Means you should complete that work on time and start on time. Next level is punctuality. When I talk about punctuality, it means you should go to your workplace on time, start your work on time, complete your work on time, and do your dedication towards your work as well. This skill should be in the manager, because a manager should behave properly with their subordinates, especially the employees who are new. They should not feel that they are humiliated by their bosses and their bosses are rude while talking to them. Work should be allotted in a manner that they do not feel that they are nowhere in the organization or they are new in the organization. Not wasting your time. It means you should not waste your time while doing some unnecessary things while you are working, because time plays an important role while achieving. So there are cut-off times for each and every file. So you should not waste your time and do your work with discipline, punctuality, so that it completes on time. Dignity of work. Dignity of work means nothing but you should give your 100% your level best in the organization. There should be no wastage of time. You should be creative that how your work can be done more accurately. So that is dignity of work. So you should surrender yourself fully while doing anything in the organization. The next step is doing morally correct things. You should be morally culture plays a very important role in each and every organization, and it differs from one organization to another organization. An employee has to work in an environment where he is able to speak up, where his ideas are also welcome. So work culture plays a very important role in and productivity of an employee and his performance appraisal. Commitment. You should always commit yourself towards your work so the desired result is accomplished. Whatever work you are doing in an organization, you should fully commit yourself towards it. Next point is sense of belongingness. When I talk about sense of belongingness, it means how friendly or how personal touch an organization gives to their employees. For example, there are some companies which celebrates birthdays of their employees, and there are some companies which gives holidays on their birthdays of the employees, which makes the employees feel that they are important in the organization and they are the asset of the organization. Presenting favorable image of the organization. In whichever organization you are working, you should always try to present a positive image of that organization. You should never try to spoil that image of the organization. Now we'll study dimension of work ethos. Under that, organization interest protection. You should always try to protect the interests of the organization. You should not try to spoil whatever the interest of the organization is all about, and try to be a good employee for the organization and towards yourself. Proper system in the organization so that the information flows from top to bottom and there is no loopholes in between. Whatever the board of director has spoken, it reaches to the lower level of the organization or the employee so that there is no miscommunication in between. So system is properly planned in that way. Proper communication system, it means a proper channel of communication from top level to the lower level of the management. Whatever the information has to be informed to the lower level of the management is passed through the board of directors in a very effective manner. Next is sense of loyalty towards the organization. You should always show your loyalty towards the organization, which is then seen and observed by the organization, and you get a proper appraisal also after that. But first thing is you are morally correct and showing your loyalty is very much important. The next point is discipline. As discussed earlier, you are in the organization, you should always work with the discipline in a manner which is not hurting yourself also and others also. Four P's of work ethics, that is product, price, pace, promotion. When I talk about product, a product should be designed in such a manner that it gets sold in the market. Then pricing of the product should be very economical that all people can buy it. Product, price, pace. Place, the place you are selling those products should be suitable for that particular type of citizen, and promotion should be done at most level so that it reaches the information to that particular group where you are trying to sell those products. Now we'll understand what are different steps in work ethos with an organization to perform. designation or lead the organization. Wages to productivity. The more the productivity, the more wages would be earned by the worker. This will give the feeling of that, yes, I can do the work more effectively and productively, so I can earn money properly. The next point is attendance bonus. Always try to give attendance bonus to the employees so that his presence plays an importance in the organization and he feels like he is rewarded for his importance in the organization. This point is rewarding employees. Always try to give rewards to the employees. For example, some companies or the organization have thank you giving points to the employees. They give some reward points to the employees so that they get extra sum in their salary. Some gives discounts on these sports brands or some luxury products. So that is nothing but feeling and rewarding those employees that yes, your work has been rewarded by the organization. Employees' participation in decision making. Always try to put in hopes from the employees so that they can help you to make a decision on particular issues in the organization. No political interference. There should be no politics played in the organization. This should be avoided as far as possible. There are some organizations which start their offices while doing prayers in the organization. They thank God for being in the organization and starting their day. Now we'll study what are different factors responsible for poor work ethics. Under that, the first one is lack of commitment. If there is no commitment towards your work, you cannot expect a successful outcome from it. Lack of discipline. If you are not disciplined while performing your duty or your work, then there will be no proper outcome of it and it will be like a haywire in between. Poor working condition. The workplace where you are working, it's not proper. Then the employee might not be able to give their 100% and hence they will have the effect on their work. Political interference. If there is an excessive political interference, then the work might not be accomplished as desired for. Decline in moral standards. If we do not perform work according to our morals and the standards norm, then there will be a decline in the productivity, hence profit will also be affected. Lack of recognition. For example, if an employee has worked very good in an uncertain important work and he is not recognized by his bosses or the manager, he might feel very demotivated and sometimes he might not get his 100% while performing his duties or work which he is told. High rate of absenteeism. If you are not recognized for your work, then there might be absenteeism in the organization which may have direct impact on the productivity and profit of the organization. If you are overloaded or overburdened with the work, you might not give your 100% in doing the work because you have many things in the line to do and hence your productivity is not the same as the before. Hence it will impact your performance. Now workload has direct impact to stress. If we have heavy workloads, we are not able to manage it and hence we are stressed out. So kisi cheez ki zyada chinta karna hamare swasthya ke liye bahut hanikarak hai. Lack of heroic clarity. Now this is very important in an organization. The work which you are supposed to do should be very clearly stated to you. If it is not done properly, then there will be a misunderstanding between the employer and the employer, the manager and the employee. Now let us understand what is value. Value is nothing but our beliefs that guides our behavior. The way we behave is our value. हमारे संस्कार जो हमें घर से सिखाए जाते हैं, हम उसी तरह फिर व्यवहार करने लगते हैं और उससे हमारा व्यक्तित्व भी उभरता है. Let us now understand different features of value. Under that, the first is core of personality. Personality is nothing but the way we act, the way we wear clothes, the way our culture is shows our personality. हमारा व्यक्तित्व हमारी personality होती है. हम कैसे बात करते हैं, कैसे लोगों से आदर किए व्यवहार करते हैं, वो हमारी personality से झलकता है. और ये सब हमारे संस्कार हमें जो घर में सिखाए जाते हैं, जिससे हम बड़े होते हैं, उसी पे निर्भर करता है. Values are relatively stable. When I talk about values are relatively stable, there is always a conflict between the feeling and the values. Feelings are temporary, which occurs on the situation. Yes, I want to do this, but values says no, it is not ethical, we will not do it. Always give importance to your values because those plays a very important role in building. Subjective in nature. Values are subjective in nature in a form of any conflict situation which we have to give a lot of thinking that yes, we have to go ahead with certain things or no. So values plays a very important role in thinking and finding out solution in that. Values are cultured at home. हम जहाँ हमारे घर का वातावरण, हमारे संस्कार, हमारे घर से आते हैं, हमें ये सब हमारे घर से ही शिक्षा दी जाती है. Values are always inculcated in us inside us, so we believe in ourselves, we learn values and we behave in that. Emotionally charged value keeps us emotionally stable. It gives us stability while we are going through an emotional moments in our life. Values are always learned because it is taught by our own. Now we will understand what are different values for a manager. A manager should be respectful towards their employees. He should give respect towards their employees and the subordinates and the superior bosses also. He should be committed towards his work. He should be very creative while thinking of the solution so that he does not harm any employees and the work is not affected also. Open-mindedness, a manager should be open while thinking with the situation and dealing with the situation. He should be positive while thinking and dealing with the condition which he is going through. Fearless, a manager should be fearless while dealing with the situation. If he thinks that this problem is very big, he should contact his employees or the superior bosses and should not have fear of saying any situation to them or stating any situation to them. He should be very optimistic if he has judgment or point of view in some situation. He should open it to his superiors. Calmness, he should be very polite while dealing with the situation or talking to his employees. Calmness plays a very important role in working situations. Then he should be very accountable while doing the work and he should be a delegator because management is the art of getting things done to others and manager has to perform that duty. And once you are doing it, you have to take care of yourself also, your words also and your behavior also. Now let us understand impact of values on stakeholders. Who are your stakeholders? Yes, employees is also your stakeholders. Your customers are your stakeholders. Government is also your stakeholders. Competitors is also there and the society. So in this, I will like to give you example of the movie Guru, where Abhishek Bachchan, when he starts his empire from a small room to a big organization, the way he interacts with the customer, the way he deals with the tricky situation, the way he gives permission to the authorities and take permission from the authorities shows that he has a perfect value and leadership qualities. Now let us understand importance of value system in work culture. Whenever an MNC is forming their business in the host country, then they have to understand the culture of that particular country because they have to conduct the business in that country and they have to make profit. For that, they have to understand the culture of different region in that particular country where they are operating their business. They have to understand the work culture between the employees, the citizen of that country, so that they can be more productive while performing their duty. Corporate culture plays a very important role and values help corporates to understand the culture of a particular region and then they can be formed properly. Values helps us to guide the action in the organization. So it helps us to form the standards which an organization and has to follow and even the employees working in the organization have to follow the standards which are mentioned over there. Social responsibility towards the employees and towards the society where we are performing the business is very important for a corporate and their culture. Humanity and respect for all. Whenever we talk about values, culture, there comes humanity, and humanity leads to respect for all. We should take respect and we should give respect also. Next is accountability and responsibility. Whenever work is delegated, take the responsibility and also try to share your responsibility, which will give you the feeling of belongingness, and the appraisal is also done on the performance basis. Then comes cooperation and team spirit. A single player will not be able to win the match. If the whole 12 players play together, then only a match can be won. So that is nothing but team spirit. A team should be happy, the employees should work with each other with a feeling of friendliness so that the work is accomplished in a proper and effective manner and the productivity is raised so that the profit is also raised in the organization.